Hi, I'm Kayleigh Dowd and I'm going to show you how to get the best out of this little beauty, the Jigger float. So for those of you that don't know what a jigger float is, or I've never seen one or used one, did come about a few years ago now, and it's a deadly tactic for F1s mainly, but can be used with other species. So this is a jigger float. As you can see, it's like a little pea body float with the line that passes through. So it's hollow in the middle. You pass your line through it and it's weighted at the bottom. And what you do then is you've got a bulk of shot at the bottom and you're literally lowering your bait, so whether you're using maggots, casters, pellets, just like you would for shallow fishing, you're lowering it through the layers of the water and jigging the bait, so when the fish sees it, they home in on it and it hooks itself basically. So as soon as the fish has it, hooks itself and away you go. So now I'll show you how you set one up and how to use one. So this is the actual rig that I use when jigger fishing. Dead simple. Rigs don't get much easier than this, to be honest. It's literally a piece of line, some shot and a hook length. But in a little bit more detail, what I do is, main line's got to be quite strong and robust. If you think the fish, when you're fishing, it's coming up and down quite a lot. The float's moving up and down, it's going over your net. So I opt for 017 power line as main line when I'm doing this sort of fishing. And then down to just above the hook length, I've got a bulker shot, that's just so I can control the speed in which I lower the bait through the water at. And they're just number 9 strung out, I've got 6 on there. And then a 2-inch hook length of 013 power line. So I like a dead shallow hook length, just because then fish do come right up in the water. And if you've got a shallow hook length, as soon as it's in, you're fishing straight away. And then up at the top, some fisheries have rules on, you can't have a lash longer or shorter than a certain amount, so here at Lindholme it's 8 inches, so I've just got to stop up there and that just stops the float moving any higher than 8 inches to the elastic. So just going back to the hook length for a minute, as I've said, I'm fishing a 2-inch hook length here, and that's dead important. Unlike any normal shallow fishing, the main advantage of fishing a jigger is you can fish dead shallow, shallower than what you can on a normal rig, by lowering it in and you're fishing straight away. So that is one of the main advantages of jigger fishing. And then, as with all my F1 fishing, got a short kit, 11 Jura slip through it, and a puller, and that's all you need. So we're just going to have a quick look at what bait you use when jigger fishing, and to be honest it's exactly the same as what you'd use when shallow fishing for F1s. So as you can see, got natural baits, maggots, casters work really well, as well as pellets. Most F1s have been reared on pellets all their life and it is a good go-to bait. Over here got a bit of slop, so crushed expander, over wetted, makes a lovely cloud, and this is really good in the height of summer. Well, you've got quite a few new fish, so you've got newly stocked F1s, it's really warm and it just brings them really high in the water, so they get competing, sometimes splash about, climb out of water and get in a real frenzy for it. But like on its day, maggots and casters can be better than pellets, so it's worth just having them options available and seeing what works for you. I'm going to talk you through how I go about actually fishing a jigger and baiting it up. So we're fishing live maggots today. I've just got a live maggot out and I'm just going to kill it. So to do that, I'm just going to literally roll it in my fingers a few times and hope it don't pop. Then once that's dead, get my banding tool, stick it in my band, and open it up, and then just put my maggot into the band, pull it off, and there we go. That should stay on now, catch a couple of fish at least. So then we'll ship out to the area where we intend to fish and fire some maggots in. So with a jigger, as I've said, you've got your weight underneath, and that line now is pulling down through. Oh, it went away then, the one on. It's pulling down through the middle of the line. So I'm firing my maggots in and around that area, as close to it as I can, and then just letting it go down and just jigging so that as it falls down, let it fall a bit, and then just give it a little jig which wafts the bait, and then it'll fall again. And just keep repeating this process until there's a fish on. So just like any other shallow fishing that we do, I've actually got three different size jiggers set up. By that I mean depths. So I've got a shallow one, this is a middle one, and I've got a deeper one. So if they do come shallower, you want to be direct with them straight away, and then as they drop down, use this one, just search that middle part, and then if you stop getting bites, the chances are they've dropped even deeper. So it's worth having that rig set up just that foot or so deeper, just in case they drop down, and then if you start foul looking them or missing bites, come back up shallower and you'll be back in contact with the fish. Keep going. Ooh. There we go. Didn't take too long once you get that feeding accurate. Jigging your maggot up and down in the middle of the pile, and it just stands out that bit more and they can't resist it. There we go. Nice big Benny's F1. In you go. There we go. Nice little fat lump in. Look at that. Lovely. Slip me hook out. Pop him in the net. There we go, my maggot's still in. Make it a bit more central. Back out for the next one. Get this one in, and then I'll talk through why I fish a jigger over a fixed float. There you go. Another lovely F1. I'll get back out, feed a few maggots and run you through. So the main reasons why I actually like to fish, or why we fish jiggers over a fixed float. So I'd say there's three main reasons, probably a few more as well. But it's to search the depth. So with a fixed float, you can only fish whatever depth you've set the float at. And obviously you'll have to come in and out, change your depth just to see if there's fish there. Whereas with a jigger, you can search whatever length of line you put on. That's the depth that you can search. So this is like 2 or 3 foot. So I can go all the way down to 3 foot and see if there's any fish there. Oh, not the fish that we wanted, but there's fish there. We'll get that one in. So that's the main reason that we fish a jigger float, is to look at the depths and see if we can find the depths where the fish are. So I'd say the second reason that we fish it is you can fish it really shallow. When you're fishing a fixed float, it's hard to fish shallower than, I'd say, 6-8 inches, just because you've got the depth of the float, the length of the float, as well as your hook length. So it makes it a bit tricky. Whereas with this, you've got no float really. You've got half an inch, if that, which is your float, and you can put a couple of inch hook length underneath that, so you can realistically be fishing 2 inches deep, which the fish, if they're coming up from below, they'll be taking your bait at that depth, and you can't, you just can't fish that deep, that shallow when you've got a fixed rig. So that's another main advantage of this float and this style of fishing. Let's keep them maggots going in. And another main advantage is that it's a self-hooking rig, so you don't miss bites or anything. When the fish takes your bait, it hooks itself and it's on. There's no messing around getting these funny little indications that we all know F1s are notorious for. They don't like to play the game sometimes. Whereas with this, because you're jigging, when you jig, that's when you normally hook into them, or they'll literally just pull your elastic out and there's no way of striking. You just got fish on. Simple as that. Like that. Even with a smaller fish, you don't get a bite because the line goes straight through the middle of the float, so you don't really get an indication as such. It's fish on. So a little tip that I will give you when jigger fishing is make them up day before, and rather than storing them on a wine like we do a normal conventional rig, obviously when it goes round it does kink a little, and sometimes when you are actually fishing it, if the line's got kinks in it, it don't flow as nicely. So make them up, put them on your top kit, ready to go, and it does save time on the bank as well. So when you get there, your rigs are already on your top kit, so all you've got to do is put them on the side and away you go. Like I say, fish on. Like I say, if you do make them and store them on winders because you don't have any other option, just don't make the line too tight. You try to reduce the kinks, but they are really easy to make. Like I say, a piece of line, some short and a hook length, that is it. Let's have a look at the next culprit. There we go, putting up a bit of a fight. Lovely elastic for this sort of job. 11 Jura slip. Perfect for small F1s and small carp, big F1s. Putting up a bit of a scrap. There we go. Probably a nice one to end it on, to be honest. I've had a lovely day's fishing. Hope you've enjoyed. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. So if you've enjoyed this video and want to see plenty more like this, don't forget to subscribe to the Preston Innovations YouTube channel. Completely free, and it's bound to put more fish in your net.